I went from almost failing at university to ranking first at one of the best global universities. But how exactly did I do that? Well, I used my secret MDMA study framework. Hey friends, Greg here, the founder of Your Inception. Welcome to my channel. Today, I want to share with you how I went from almost failing at a very average university to ranking first at one of the best global universities. And in this video, I want to share with you my four-step MDMA study framework. I know the name sounds funny and it may remind you of something else, but don't worry, I didn't use any illegal substances, at least not to improve my exam scores. Now, the third step of this four-step process is very controversial, so bear with me. Now, before I was accepted to master studies at Lund University, which used to be at around 50 to 60 best universities in the world and number first or number second in Sweden, I was actually failing at a very average university, School of Economics, where I was studying. My average score was about 6.7, which is just about passing, and it was really, really bad. I was one of the worst students of the year. And since I had no motivation, but I knew I somehow had to pass the exams and try to get good grades, at least have a chance to get a good job after, at least that was my plan back then, I knew I had to change something, but I wasn't sure what or how to do it. And then I decided to apply to this amazing university, and I said to myself, if I'm accepted, I'll be the best student of the year. How? Well, that's what I didn't know. And a couple of months later, I was actually accepted to study master's at this university, and the program was one of the best global programs you can find. So I was really somehow motivated to get there, to move to Sweden and try to finish this school. And at the same time, I was really scared because I had no idea how I'm gonna do that. So I started discovering, started reading different books on productivity, on focus, on memory, because those were the issues I really had back then. And eventually I managed to develop this MDMA study framework, which helped me became number one, the best student of the year. Now the first step of this four-step process is motivation. Now this is an obvious one. If you wanna finish or be good at any university, you need motivation, you need to be motivated. Now, what motivates you, I don't know, you have to find something for yourself. But there's one trick that I used. So when I moved abroad for the studying, I actually decided to imagine I live in this movie, basically. I created my new imaginary world where I'm studying abroad. I was in Sweden, which was very cold during the winter. There wasn't much sunlight, basically much light at all, because it got dark pretty quickly. So I was alone, I didn't have many friends, and it was a perfect situation where I was able to create this imaginary story where I'm in this movie, I'm the main character, and I have to work hard, I have to be focused, and I have to finish all the stuff that I want to finish successfully, because otherwise I will fail. And being alone really, really helped me do that. And maybe this is one of the ways that can help you increase or improve your motivation. But anyway, find something for yourself. If this is like, if you have some end goals, like great career, family, traveling, even like material stuff, that doesn't matter to me. What's important is you need to find motivation. And if creating some imaginary story helps, well, just go for it. Now, the second most important step was daily routine. I knew that if I want to be successful, I need some kind of a routine that I'll follow, because otherwise, with so many opportunities like partying and stuff, I will probably just fail. So I made a very simple daily routine. After I woke up, I did 5 to 10 minutes meditation. I didn't know anything about meditation before, but I just, you know, used different apps. I used Calm back then, and it did the trick. So I tried to stay focused for a couple of minutes, tried to get more relaxed, and after doing meditation, I went for a quick run, 15 to 20 minutes, not more than that. And this helped me get some energy. This helped me, you know, feel refreshed every single morning and relax at the same time. And once I get back from the run, I took a shower. Sometimes it was cold shower, which gave you more energy. Sometimes just a normal shower. And then I ate a healthy breakfast. I usually went for oatmeal with blueberries, some bananas, almond milk. Sometimes I ate eggs. I don't eat eggs anymore, but yeah, that really worked for me. That was like two very quick meals to prepare, very affordable, and they gave me the energy. And one really cool thing I did during the breakfast is I took my notebook and I wrote down the number one goal of the day. So I said, what is that I want to achieve this day? Is it that I want to study something? I want to learn something? Do I want to finish an exam? Do I want to prepare for an exam? Do I want to, you know, there's a project I have to finish or whatever. So that's what I wrote down during breakfast. And when I was eating and writing this down, I already started thinking on how I'm gonna accomplish that. And after breakfast, I prepared Bulletproof Coffee. This is a basic coffee with some MCT oil in and some butter. You can read all about it up here or watch my full review. And this gave me lots of energy, lots of stamina that I needed to be able to focus and to be able to learn and remember lots of things. By the way, guys, if you wanna learn all about how you can get in the flow every single day, I prepared some videos for you. You can check them out there or in the description below. And yeah, check them out. They're really, really powerful. Now the third step of this MDMA process, it's memory tricks. So I knew I had a really bad memory. It's still true, basically. I'm still, I have issues with remembering names. I have issues with remembering certain dates and stuff like this. But you know, being at the university, this doesn't really help. It's not an excuse, right? You can't go to your professor and say, hey, sorry, my memory is really bad. So yeah, can you just give me a better grade here? That's not gonna happen. So I need to do something. And that's how I came across the book called Moonwalking with Einstein. And this book was actually the first book I read about memory, how you can actually improve your memory that's gonna serve you better for the stuff that you need. One of the first things that I started doing after reading the book was I started playing this so-called dual and back game. This is a memory slash focus game that can dramatically improve your memory and focus at the same time. It's very challenging. In the beginning, not, but it gets very, very challenging when you progress for different levels. And this one quickly doubled my memory. It actually improved memory so much that I was really shocked at certain moments that I can remember so many things. Of course, after I stopped playing the game, my memory went back to normal after a couple of weeks, of course, not immediately. But during the time when I was playing the game, it was a real, real game changer. So I started playing this game for about 20 minutes every single day. In addition to that, I started using a thing called Memory Palace. If you read the book I mentioned before, if you just Google Memory Palace, you're gonna find lots of useful content on that. Now, Memory Palace, by definition, is basically a location in your mind that you know very well. This can be your house where you live or you used to live as a kid, or a spot where you went to vacation many times. So a place that you know very much into details. Usually it's an interior part because you need to remember like where is a wardrobe, where is a chair, where like all the small parts and bits of this location. And you can use this to place different images, they're so-called mnemonic images, on different places within this place in your mind. And once you walk through this place, at least in your mind, you can then remember what you placed on different positions. And it's so much easier to remember the words that you placed there, or different stuff, different products, different things that you need to remember. This is one of the best tricks that memory champions, you know, there are competitions, memory competitions around the world, they use that to remember thousands of different things. While it sounds a bit challenging, it actually really isn't. So what I did is, I know my place back home, a house where I lived as a kid, very well. So I imagined this place in my mind, and then whenever I had to remember a different string of different stuff, very complex words or phrases or some strategies and stuff, I put those words in different ways on different positions in this house. And whenever I had to remember that during an exam usually, I went back into this home through my mind, obviously, and I tried to remember what I placed where. And this made a huge, huge difference. And the last memory trick that I used is whenever there was a hard, difficult word that I had to remember, obviously I'm not a native English speaker, I even had more issues with that, is I separated the whole word into smaller parts. And that helped me remember each part separately. And I was able to make this very crazy image of each singular part. And once I combined these images together, I was able to remember really, really hard words. Now, to give an example, there is a word that I found, it's called indefatigable, and actually means persisting tirelessly. So how would I separate this word? Well, basically, indefatigable, there's in the beginning. So in means you're in something. Then there's defeat. So I would say this also means, or very close to defeat, right? So I would remember defeat. Then there's IG. IG can stand for Instagram. I would remember Instagram. And then at the end, there's a thing called able, right? Able means you can do something, right? So what we get is you're in something, there's a defeat, and there's Instagram, and you can do that. So basically how I'd remember this is, I would remember the whole situation. So I'm in Instagram, or browsing in Instagram, and I'm showing people how I'm able to defeat other people. And then you can make this very crazy image how you actually defeat people, like with swords or, you know, in any different way, that it really has to be weird. And then you will always remember this whole scene. So once you are, once you have an exam or whatever, and you need to remember those crazy, difficult words to remember, you just go back and say, okay, what was I doing back then? And say, well, I was on Instagram trying to show everyone I'm able to defeat people. Yeah, so I was thinking of the word indefatigable. And this trick is a bit harder. It takes some time that you remember how to do it properly, but once you do, and once you have really hard words that you need to remember, it always works. And last but not least, the fourth step of this process is I had to make an action plan. So obviously with many exams, it was really hard to plan everything in advance. So here's what I did. First of all, I tried to calculate how many words can I read per minute. Obviously, a normal book, you can read 200 to 300 words per minute if you're an average reader. I am, so especially when I read in English, usually that's kind of the speed that I read with. However, when I was reading study cases or textbooks, I read even slower, obviously, because I had to, you know, mark certain things down, read it twice or three times soon. So I calculated this number, and then I checked how many pages do I have to read to prepare for the exam. And then I made an assumption of how many times do I have to read all those pages to remember everything I need to remember. Usually I had to read the same page 3 to 4 times, even more, to really remember everything. And, you know, then I just calculated everything, and it was much easier for me to kind of make an assumption on, you know, how much in advance do I have to start preparing for the exam. Also, calculate like how many hours per day am I willing to study for the exam, or how many days or how many hours per day do I have time available. And yeah, as I said, I calculate everything and I have a very clear image in front of me. And because of that, it was very easy to pass all the exams. As a result, I was chosen as the best student of the year. And the most important is that at the same time when I was studying at university, I was also starting my first company, my first startup, and I could do both things together. It was challenging, but I still managed to do them without any big struggles. And the coolest thing is that even today in my business life, I can still use all the same tricks, all the same strategies to remember things, to be motivated, to of course plan things as good as possible. And I still can remember many things, especially I use the same memory tricks now and then when I had to remember really hard and important things. And that's really, really cool. So once you learn the whole process, it can serve you for weeks, months, or even for your whole life. And that's really cool. All right, guys, so much about my MDMA study framework. I hope you liked it. Please don't forget to follow Your Inception on Facebook and Instagram. Don't forget liking this video. And if you found it useful, please share it with your friends. I would be super happy about it. All right, guys, I hope to see you soon again.